Well, you were watching that in the garage. We were watching it on the television and we found it exciting. How was it for you?
It was really exciting. I mean, I've only been to one before, Monaco. But now I see what George was so passionate about. It's just adrenaline, you know. It's fantastic. You know, the guys were giving me the information in there, so I'm hooked.
Great, because George Harrison loved his Formula One, didn't he?
Well, George, he used to, I have to tell you this, he used to dress up in all sorts of gear, hide in the back of the Jordan pits for some time, but he was a huge Damon Hill fan.
Yeah, yeah.
And he got off on it and he just loved it.
Yeah, he did, yeah. And like I say, I feel emotional today because, you know, it's like he's here with me. It's beautiful anyway. I love it.
Great. Now, the most important question, are we interrupting your honeymoon or are you interrupting your honeymoon to come and watch a Formula One race?
No, this is part of it.
Is it?
This is part.
You're a lucky man.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Well, you know, the British boys are going to win, you know, hopefully tomorrow because we're in town and vibing it up. What do you think of that?
I'm going to go back. Forget that motor racing for a moment. 50 years ago, I remember walking down the streets of Dublin to crowd my way through this massive crowd for the Beatles. Does it ever worry you 50 years later how big an influence the Beatles were on all our lives?
No, it doesn't. I'm very proud of it. You know, I think we could have kind of put out a message that was a bad message. I think we kind of put out a pretty good message, so I'm very proud of it. I'm a lucky man.
Well, we know that too, but so are we. We're all very lucky.
And we know why you're here this weekend. Lewis Hamilton has invited you into the garage. He's clearly a fan of music legends at the moment. He had Bob Marley on his helmet a couple of weeks ago, and now you're here cheering him on. How did that come about?
Excellent. Well, I don't know. Somebody just invited me in. I didn't know it was Lewis. But I'm very pleased to be here anyway in Abu Dhabi doing the gig tomorrow night. And it's just great to come down and see this firsthand right there, you know, right there. Hearing that noise, seeing the cars, it's pretty hot stuff.
How does it compare to being on stage in front of a few thousand people, being here, soaking up the atmosphere of Formula One cars?
It's kind of similarities, you know, yeah. I mean, I'll get the big feedback off the audience, you know, you don't get here. But it's pretty great.
Right, I'm not sure why Eddie is doing this.
I'm sorry, I have to do this because Children in Need, we've started out something. I wore this amazing Indian shirt.
I saw you on the telly wearing that, yeah.
Now, do you know what's going to happen next? Yeah. I'm going to ask you to sign this for our kids.
I hope you are.
Because every driver is going to do that. And if we add Paul McCartney to that, I think we will have something. Did I fall over you, Jake? Your big feet, Jake has. So we think we will add significantly to the Children in Need. And the pen is here. So we can
hold that side for me.
And we'll do this on live television, so there's no doubt about the authenticity of the signature. And this will have my dad paying over the odds for this shirt. There we go. Sir Paul McCartney at the Grand Prix, performing here this weekend and signing the shirt for Children in Need.
Abu Dhabi.
Wow.
All right, man.
We're even more impressed the fact that he would watch the BBC, no less, for the from India last weekend. Thanks, George.
Great. All right, guys. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Paul. Thank you. Thanks.
Cheers. Good luck with that.
All the very best. Right, so there you go. The shirt has been signed by Sir Paul McCartney.